हरिः ओम्, नमः सर्वेभ्यः। अद्य विंशत्युत्तरद्विसहस्रतमवर्षस्य मार्च् मासस्य पञ्चदशे दिनाङ्के गीताप्रवेशस्य प्रथमभागस्य द्वात्रिंशत्तमे कक्षार्थं सर्वेभ्यः स्वागतम्। वेन् वि जायिन् टु अण्ड् प्रोड्यूस् द फैनल् समस्तपदं, देर् इस् सम् प्रासेस् वि अप्ले आन् इट्, रैट्? As I said, the process which we apply may not be same all the time. It may change based on the meanings of the words we join, or based on the meaning which you want to derive at derive from the samasta padam, or maybe the words which we specifically use. If there is a particular word we want to make it as a part of the samasta, the process will change a little bit. So there are such differences we can find in the process, first thing. And second thing is, if you want to know the meaning of, for example, if this is a Sitayaha Patihi, we apply some process and we make a word called Sitapati. That's simpler one. But most of the times, the forward conversion will not happen when we read any shlokas or any katha somewhere, right? So nowhere they use a Sitayaha Patihi. They always use Sitapatihi. So that means you have to do a reverse conversion and basically kind of a reverse engineering to find out what is the original two words and what's the meaning of it, right? So most of the times it will be a reverse operation, right? So in that case, if you want to understand if you want to do a reverse operation of this samasa, there are again based on certain types of the samasa, we derive the meaning of the samasta padam. So there are certain types of samasa. Based on that, we derive the meaning of the samasta padam. Unless we know what type the samasa is, we cannot get exact meaning. So when we reverse the Sitapati to Sitayahapati, this is one of the reverse engineering process where we get the Sitayahapati as the result. But there are multiple ways, multiple meanings we can derive from the Sitapati. But that will be decided by the type of the samasa which we use in that sentence, in that samasta padam. So basically, the type based on the how do we generate a meaning of the samasta padam, how do we judge the meaning of the samasta padam, that is actually based on the type of the samasa. So in that case, it is very important to know the types of the samasa. And before we getting to the getting to know about the types of the samasa, we will try to understand how little more details of how Sitayaha Patihi becomes Sitapati. So what is the process involved in the middle? So that we will try to understand here, and then we will go to the types of the samasa. So samasa prakriya, so Sitayaha Patihi. So this is the actual meaning with which we wanted to produce a single samasta padam called Sitapati. Okay, the process goes like this: Sitayaha Patihi. There are two words. Okay, this Sitayaha Patihi, the whatever we say, that is called as Laukika Vigraha. So whatever the final word which appears, like a Sitapati, that is the samasta padam. And before the samasta padam, we use two raw padams, raw words which we use to join. Not raw words, maybe the meaning of the samasta padam, like Sitayaha Patihi is the meaning of the samasta padam. So that meaning, we can call it as a Laukika Vigraha. So Laukika Vigraha means the meaning of the samasta padam. Okay. So let's take Sitayaha Patihi. So when we want to join these two words, then what happens is, we have to split the words like Pratipadikam plus Pratyaya. The Pratyaya is nothing but the Vibhakti Pratyaya. So for example, Ramaha, if you take, the Pratipadikam is Rama and the Vibhakti Pratyaya is Su. Right, Ramasya, again the Pratipadikam will be Rama plus Vibhakti Pratyaya is the Shashti Ekavachana Pratyaya. So in that way, Sitayaha, if you take, it will be Sita plus Nyas. Okay, the Sita is a Pratipadikam on which we add a vibhakti pratyaya called nyas. That actually, the nyas is nothing but the shashti ekavachana pratyaya. Ekavachane shashti vibhakti pratyaya is nyas. So when we add nyas to the sita, it becomes the sitayaha. Similarly, patihi. So patihi is again prathama vibhakti ekavachanam. So it will be pati plus su. So again, so basically the idea here is that we take the pratipadikam. Sita plus nyas, pati plus su. Okay, so this is the combination. Basically sita plus nyas plus patihi, pati plus su. So this gives the sita yaha patihi. So whatever, how, when we split like pratipadikam and pratyaya, vibhakti pratyaya for both the words, that set is called as alaukika vigraha. Okay, hope we are able to understand that laukika vigraha is the direct laukika meaning of the samasta padam sita yaha patihi, and alaukika vigraha is whichever two words we want to join, split those words with pratipadikam plus vibhakti pratyaya, like that, like sita nyas pati psu. So that is called as alaukika vigraha. Okay, the now next process is to drop off the vibhakti pratyas. So nyas will be dropped off, su will be dropped off. So we will take only sita and pati. Okay, so here what that means, the pratipadikam of the first word, the pratipadikam of the second word, that's what is remains. We take those two and we try to join them. Okay, so when we join, of course there will be a possibility of having sandhi. If so, apply the sandhi, then join the join those two words. If there is no possibility, just join as it is. Okay, but when we join like this, when we join and when we want to apply a sandhi, remember that we studied while doing the sandhi, we might have studied the sandhi will happen, there are certain sandhis will happen at the padanta, certain cases will happen within the pada or between the padams, like that, right? So in this case, sita is considered as a single padam and pati is considered as another padam. So that means if the sandhi is applied, it's like a sandhi is applied between the padams here. Okay, so now accordingly you can go back and check all the sandhi rules wherever the padam word is there, like you can remember like padante jash bhavati, like apadante padante, like these kind of terminologies might have come across during our sandhi study. So remember this, these two words are the padams, individual padams, these are not the same padam. Okay, so now we apply a sandhi rule, if there is any sandhi possible, then we produce the final word called sitapati. Okay, when we produce the sitapati, this is no more padam. This still here sita is a padam, kind of a pati is, pati is also padam, but after we join, sitapati is not a padam, it becomes the name called, it is called as pratipadikam. So this is the samasta pratipadikam, like we join those two and we produce a pratipadikam, that is the samasta pratipadikam. Okay, now based on the sentence which you want to use, we can add the corresponding vibhakti pratyaya to it. Okay, so like sitapati, if you want to use it as a prathama bhakti, like sitapati hi agachati, so in that case prathama bhakti ekavachana vibhakti pratyaya is su, so we add and we produce sitapati hi. Okay, suppose if you want to maybe tritiya, or if you want to use dutiya, so sitapatim, that corresponding vibhakti pratyaya will be attached to it. So here the sitapati is a samasta pratipadikam and the final sitapati is a samasta padam. The padam, always we know that subantam or tingantam is what we called it as a padam. So pratipadikam plus supratyaya, that will result into the padam, that is what we call it as a subantam, that is what we call it as a samasta padam. Okay, and one more thing is, in the samasta padam, when we have a sita patihi, there are two words, right? Sita is a one word and pati is actually in the, from sitayaha patihi sita pati askam. The first word, whatever in the samasta padam, whatever appears at the beginning or the first part of the samasta padam is called as purva padam. So sita is a purva padam and pati, which appears later in the samasta padam, that's called as uttara padam. So remember, the purva padam or uttara padam is decided based on the samasta padam, not based on the laukika vigraha or this alaukika vigraha. Okay, maybe in the laukika vigraha the words might have been interchanged, but still at the samasta padam, whatever appears at the beginning of the samasta padam, that is called as purva padam. Whatever appears later part of the samasta padam is called as uttara padam. Okay, so this slide will introduce you a lot of new terminologies related to the samasa. So, and the main important thing is we drop the vibhakti pratyayas of original words and we join them. While we join, we apply all the sandhi rules, considering these two both are independent padams, and we produce a pratipadikam. And on pratipadikam, based on the usage, based on the sentence, we attach corresponding vibhakti pratyaya to produce the final samasta padam. So there are few things. This is a very high level prakriya for the samasa, but not necessarily it will go in the same way. There will be some additional steps might have been added, may get added, like sometimes based on the samasa which you want to form or based on the words which we choose to join, there may be some reversal, like purva padam may become a second and uttara padam may become a first, or maybe there may be some special adeshas may get applied on the, in this case sita just added as a sita at the end of the sentence, but when we take a special words like mahat or any such words, mahat will not be actually as a mahat, sometimes it will be replaced as maha. So that kind of replacement or adeshas will happen, sometimes the swappings or sometimes some extra new words in the middle. So lot of such things happen based on the type of the samasa which we deal with. So all those things we will learn slowly in the going further, but this is a high level process for any samasa. So that's all for today. Thanks for watching this video online. Let us meet in the next session. But for any queries or if you want to interact with teachers or students, please log into forum.sanskrit.today and subscribe to this channel Sanskrit.Today to watch more videos like this. Share this video with your friends and interested people or group. And make use of the comment section below the video if you have any suggestions or feedback about this session or series. And click on the like button of this video if you like this. Thank you. Thanks for watching this video online. Let us meet in the next session. Dhanyavadaha.